Hello students, I am Anju Mathur of Rawal Convent School. Today I am going to explain you the poem Milk for the Cat by Harold Monroe. Before moving to the explanation, let's learn about the poet of the poem. Harold Edward Monroe was born on 14th March 1879 in the Belgian capital Brussels. He made an important contribution to the development of Great War poetry. As founder and proprietor of the poetry bookshop in Bloomsbury, and editor of his own periodical Poetry and Drama, he felt a responsibility to survey the mass of verse that began appearing as soon as the war broke out. He had poetry bookshop in London, which helped many famous poets bringing their poetry before the public. He died on 16th March 1932 at the age of 53. Milk for the Cat is a children's poem about a cat and how she gets her daily dose of milk. The cat goes to the poet's house at the 5 in the evening every day. Knowing that it is the tea time at poet's house, she appears without fail and at the right time. Now let's start the poem. First paragraph. When the tea is brought at 5 o'clock and all the neat curtains are drawn with care, the little black cat with bright green eyes is suddenly peering there. In this paragraph, the poet wants to explain when the tea is made at 5 o'clock and the curtains are still drawn at the poet's house, the cat appears by the window with its green eyes glowing and waiting patiently to give in its tea. At first, she pretends having nothing to do. She has come in merely to blink by the grate. But though tea may be late or the milk may be sour, she is never late. In this paragraph, poet wants to explain. Initially, she pretends that she is just paying a casual visit that has nothing to do with the milk she is given every day. The tea may be prepared late or the milk may turn sour, but the cat is never late to arrive. And presently her agate eyes take a soft large milky haze and her independent casual glance becomes a stiff hard gaze. In this paragraph, the poet explains as the time passes by, her hunger for milk increases. The casual, don't care look fades away from her eyes and stern, stiff, hard look appears. Then she stamps her claws or lifts her ears or twists her tail and begins to stir till suddenly all her little body becomes one breathing, trembling purr. In this paragraph, the poet explains as the cat's weight progresses, she begins to attract attention by stamping her claws and lifting her ears. And even then, when the cat fails to attract attention and milk, she begins to purr loudly. The children eat and wriggle and laugh. The two ladies stoke their silk. But the cat is grown small and the thin with desire, transformed to a creeping lust for milk. In this paragraph, the poet wants to explain the children eat, laugh and play amongst themselves, whereas the two ladies adjust their silk robes. This neglect from the house inmates make the cat's desire for its milk become stronger and stronger, so much so that her body is reduced to a small and thin mass, burning in lust for food. The white saucer, like some full moon, descends at last from the clouds of the table above. She sighs and dreams and thrills and glows, transfigured with love. In this paragraph, the poet explains, and then comes the thing that she is waiting for. Like a full moon, the saucer of the milk descends from the clouds, that is the table. The sight of her milk fills the cat with love. Happy at last, she sighs and glows out of sheer thrill. She nestles over the shining rim, buries her chin in a creamy sea. Her tail hangs loose, each drowsy paw is doubled under each bending knee. In this paragraph, the poet explains she adjusts her face above the shining rim of the saucer and gets comfortable, and then she buries her chin into the milk that looks like a creamy sea. With her paws with her paws nestled under her knees. The cat enjoys the milk while her tail hangs loose. A long, dim ecstasy holds her life. Her world is an infinite, shapeless white. Till her tongue has curled the last holy drop. Then she sinks back into the night. In this paragraph, the poet wants to say, when the cat drinks her much-awaited milk, it seems that her life is filled with long-drawn waves of slow ecstasy. She's so focused on drinking her milk, it seems as if her whole world is a never-ending pool of white milk in front of her. This trance-like state, the cat puts herself into last still. She has polished off the last drop of milk consumed with so much care as if it is the holy water. Once she is well fed, she retreats back into the night, draws and dips her body to heap. Her sleepy nerves in the great armchair lies defeated and buried deep, 3 or 4 hours unconscious there. In this paragraph, the poet wants to explain, satisfied with a heavy meal, the cat then sinks her sleepy body into the armchair. And there on the armchair, the cat falls into a heavy slumber, lying defeated by sleep, unconscious for a good 2 or 3 hours. Central idea of the poem. The milk for the cat revolves around a cat's wait for the milk that it is served every day at the poet's house. The poem follows each movement of the cat as she waits for the milk. Then the poet describes the focus with which the cat enjoys her meal and the deep sleep of satisfaction that she falls into after her meal is over. The most important theme of the poem is desire. Throughout the poem, we see how desire for its milk drives the cat in the poem to the poet's house, where it waits patiently to be served what it has come for. As the cat's wait progresses, her desire mounts more and more, until it seems that her whole body is consumed with a craving for milk. Finally, when the cat is served with the object of its desire, it is transfigured with love. The cat gets lost into its saucer of milk, drinking her cherished drink to the very last drop. Desire is one of the strongest emotions, and for animals, desire is linked to the very carnal necessities such as food. This poem paints a realistic picture of a cat that strongly desires for its milk. Another theme of the poem is routine. Animals can be creatures of habit. The cat in the poem seems to follow a stringent routine when it comes to her evening milk. Every day she visits the poet's house at 5 in the evening, knowing that she would serve milk over there. This visitation of the cat takes place without fail every day, making it a part of her daily routine. Poetic devices used in the poem. Milk for the in the third stanza, Monroe uses the simile agate eyes to describe the eyes of the cat that look like the gemstone agate. In the fifth stanza, the use of synecdoche has been made. Synecdoche is a figure of speech where a part is made to represent the whole or vice versa. Silk has been mentioned to speak about the silk robes that the ladies in the poem are wearing. That is, the whole is mentioned to refer to the part. In the seventh stanza, an extended metaphor has been used in which the saucer of milk has been compared to the moon that shines from behind the table, which has been compared to the clouds. In the eighth stanza, the poetic device of transferred epithet has been used in drowsy paws. It is not the cat's paws that are drowsy, but it is the cat that is drowsy. The attribute of the cat is transferred onto its paws. Now I want to conclude the poem. Milk for the Cat is a beautiful children's poem, where Harold Monroe paints for us a very endearing picture of a cat that visits the poet's house every day, expectant of its milk. The poem follows each and every movement of the cat, from the time it enters the poet's house till the slumber it falls into after enjoying its milk. The description is so vivid and realistic that can almost view the cat in front of us while reading the poem. I hope you are clear with the poem. Thank you.